Okay, we continue from where we left off. We had just talked about this theorem which tells us about when a power series converges and what the set of convergence looks like. We're going to run through a few examples quickly here to talk about that. Let's look at this example. 3 times x minus 2 to the power n. I think you would recognize the structure. It's a geometric structure, right? Because this is just a constant. There's no n there. So the only n is in the power of a constant. So you can see, for example, if you were to put here, for example, so what by geometric series convergence, right? What is the criteria? You need to have that common ratio x minus 2 be less than 1. What does that tell you? That x is in where? So 3 minus 2 is 1, and 1 minus 2 absolute is also 1. So x is in the interval from 1 to 3. I.e. radius 1 around C equal 2. Okay? So if you're in here, the series will converge to a finite value. If you're outside this interval, this function does not give you a value, so this function is undefined there. So its domain is only this. Now, the theorem does not mention anything about the endpoints. So you still have to check the endpoints. And here, if you plug 3 or 1 specifically, then you'll get the absolute will be exactly 1, and neither of those will converge. So the interval of convergence, yes, the radius is 1, but the interval of convergence is exactly this. So let's write that down. Interval of convergence is exactly 1 to 3. Neither of the endpoints included. Let's look at another example. Let's look at this example. Now what we're going to do is we're going to use ratio test. So we're going to look at the limit, because this is a little bit, this is not a geometric series. So we know that the ratio test tells us that we look at the limit of a sub n plus 1 over a sub n. To be careful here, what do I mean by a sub n plus 1 is not just the constant, I mean the whole thing. In the previous lecture for this topic, I was using a sub n to mean just this coefficient of it. But right now I'm just mean the whole term of the series, the n plus 1 term. We look at this ratio, right? So, let's look at it here. This is the limit as n goes to infinity of we're going to take absolute values, so forget about the minus signs. So you're going to have x to the 2n plus 1, 2n plus 2 actually, sorry, n plus 1, 2n plus 3. Because you plug in n plus 1 here, you get 2n plus 2, plus 1 more is 2n plus 3. And over 2n plus 3 factorial, divided by an, so the x, 2n plus 1 will come here, and then the 2n plus 1 factorial will come here. Okay? Now you should, I'm going through this thing a little bit fast for the sake of your lecture, so how much time you have to watch, but you should go through the steps yourself and calculate these things. So what happens? You get, this cancels and you get x squared over, let's write on the word limit. Limit as n goes to infinity of x squared over 2n plus 2 times 2n plus 3. Okay? So what can we say about the convergence of this thing? Alright, now as n goes to infinity, right, this thing gets bigger. No matter what x we think, right? X is a variable. So think of it, if I had a 5 there, is there 5 preventing this limit from going to infinity? Right? The ratio test, as long as the limit is finite, right, the series converges. So if you have, for example, here 5 squared or even 500 squared, n goes to infinity, this is going to get so big that's going to make this whole thing go to zero. So this here, what do you think is the interval of convergence? is the whole number 9. Right? Any x value you can put here, this limit will still go to 0. Okay? Let's do one more quick example here. We're going to again use the ratio test as a tool here to help ourselves with this thing. Limit as n goes to infinity of, I'm just going to go ahead and write this down. So it'll be n plus 1 factorial x to the n plus 1 over n factorial x to the n, and this equals the limit as n goes to infinity of, what do we get here? X, the 1x there, and n plus 1. So you get n plus 1 times x, times x. And we're doing the limit to infinity. The variable under the limit is n. It's the n that is increasing, increasing. For any given one value of x, x is a constant. It can be pulled out. So this will be absolute of x times the limit as n goes to infinity of n plus 1. And this limit is infinity, right? Doesn't matter how tiny or big x you have, this limit is going to be infinity, except when x is 0. Okay? Remember, this is series centered at 0. We always said that that centered point itself always will converge. So here, the interval of convergence is just plus 0. Only for x equals 0, the series converges. So think of it, the radius is 0 here. Here it was the whole number line. And here it was a finite radius, radius 2, around c equal to 2. Okay? We'll do one or two more examples to talk about the endpoint possibilities. Here neither the endpoints converge, but that doesn't have to be the case. We will continue in the next lecture.